Hello and welcome to Goa 365's Face to Face. With me today is Abida Barreto from Kankon, originally living in Margaon. Now, Abida has topped NEET for Goa. There have been around 3,000 odd students who have applied, who have answered the NEET exams, and out of that she's come first. Now, I would not like to get into details about NEET and Abida, but I won't let her speak for herself about how she did it, why she did it, what she wants to do, and generally about herself. Abida, welcome to our show.
Thank you.
Now, Abida, first of all, explain what is NEET to our audience. What exactly is NEET? How do you do it? And why do you have to do it? All the details. And then about how many Goans normally apply in India and all
that. Yes. NEET is a national level exam. So for any course in medicine, nursing, you need to answer NEET. And say medicine, that is MBBS, Ayurveda, homeopathy, all courses you need to answer NEET for admission in any colleges in India.
Okay.
And in India this year, there were around 16 lakh candidates. In Goa, around 3,000 who answered NEET this year.
Okay. And out of the 3,000, you came, you topped.
Yes, yes.
And what about all India level? How do you, now for example, there are 16 lakhs you're saying, and then there are so many colleges. So how is that thing done? How does a person get selected and go and apply and go for various colleges?
It all depends on your rank. So like the topmost, the ones that are ranked higher, you need a higher rank for that. It depends, like for AIIMS and colleges that are higher on the rank, which are better, say you need to score certain say above 600 or so, or above 650 depending on the college.
Okay.
And in Goa there is GMC, so you have to come within the cutoff.
Okay. What's the cutoff, like for example, what did you score and what is the normal cutoff for GMC and then say in something in Bombay?
Yes.
What IITs come underneath?
No.
IIMs?
No. That is all IITs engineering, that
okay.
is comes under JE.
JE. So this is only for medicine?
Medicine, then veterinary also.
Ayurvedic.
Ayurveda,
okay.
And nursing also.
Okay, okay. So in GMC and all, what is the cutoff? How do you, what are the general percentages?
See, it varies from year to year.
Okay.
So, now last year, I'm not sure exactly what was the cutoff, it was in 500s.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends on how well students do, and it's just different every year.
But basically you have to get a rank in NEET, only
yes.
then you can get into GMC.
Yes, you need to get within the certain cutoff, because there are only 180 seats in GMC.
Okay.
And then there's a reservation, belong which category
X,
you come
Y,
under.
Yeah.
That's also there. So depending on that, whether you are within the top students who have scored high, then you can get admission.
So you got into GMC basically.
That's
theoretically at least.
I have applied for GMC, but okay. The list is not out.
No. But NEET it's an all India NEET or Goa NEET. There's no specific reservations for Goa
NEET
for
is,
GMC.
NEET is all India.
Okay.
But in a medical college, say GMC, there is a state quota.
Okay.
And there's all
National
India quota. So
okay.
there's 85% of the seats are reserved for Goans,
okay.
Goan, and 15% is all India quota. So I come under the Goan state quota.
Okay, okay, fine. Okay, now explain what is NEET. What do you have to study? How do you? What do you have to do to answer NEET, to prepare for NEET, and to how big a deal is it?
Essentially, for NEET, you have to at least have passed your 12th.
Okay.
And the syllabus for NEET is 11th and 12th NCERT. Basically,
okay.
they have
okay.
something a little extra that's also there, but the question paper is based on NCERT syllabus. That is nationwide. So, Goa Board, even CBSE, it follows NCERT basically. And so, all NEET aspirants, they study for, they study the 11th syllabus, 12th syllabus, and answer NEET at every year, or say,
okay.
Yes.
So all the subjects, you can't leave out anything.
Yes, there's physics, chemistry, and bio.
Okay.
It's a 720 mark paper, and physics 180 marks, chemistry 180 marks, and bio 360 marks. So half is comes under bio.
Okay, okay. Because it's mostly for medicine and medical. Yes. Do you have to prepare for it, or you can just finish your 12th and then go, relax for something and then go and answer the exam? Is that possible?
I am, like, for me that is not possible. You need to study a certain level to get a good score in NEET, because 16 lakh people are competing for these seats.
Absolutely.
It's not going to be easy.
But do you need special, you think it's important to get special coaching or all those things? Are they important?
If you have quality teachers in your school, like I had good teachers in my school, and but I prefer to go for coaching just to understand the little extra that is there beyond NCERT. And my coaching also, the teachers were really good, so it helped me a lot.
But is it not important when you go for coaching, they'll tell you how the exam is there, what is supposed to come, type of questions, all those things. And they
yes.
do coach you, right?
It's
an advantage, right?
Yeah, not an advantage as such, because they did help me, like the pattern of NEET. Mostly the mock test helped a lot, because it's exactly the questions, no doubt, are different. But you get familiar with the pattern of the paper. And nowadays, what I used to do is, I used to go online, search for mock tests, previous year papers. And so everything is available to us. We just have to make use of these things. Also, NTA, the agency that you know, makes the test for us, that does NEET every year, they have an app called NTA Abhyas app. There are around more than 100 mock tests available on it. So, you know, we don't have any shortage of resources.
Okay.
I myself answered around 30 tests on that app.
I see. Okay.
So, you know, you have to make use of these things.
But this is besides your coaching classes?
Yes, yes.
The coaching classes, they also must be giving you your
coaching
own,
classes also did a lot of mock tests with us.
Okay. Now, is there a system wherein you have to answer NEET timings or anything specific or any... you have to follow some certain method or something like that if you want to do well. Is there anything specific, like you would like somebody who wants to answer NEET to know? Is there anything specific?
The strategy I used was, you know, go slow, go steady. And the NEET paper is around 3 hours. 3 hours, exactly 3 hours. And there are 180 questions.
Objective?
Yes, and multiple choice
questions. Multiple choice, but negative marking?
Yes, there is negative marking, minus one if you get wrong. But the thing is, it is a 3 hour paper and 180 questions. So it's like if you calculate 1 minute per question, and that's not a lot of time. Physics and all you need to solve, right, for many questions. So time management is also very important. That's why practicing the tests before the actual NEET test is also important.
You mean mock test?
Yes.
Mainly. Because, yeah, so that means you need to, there has to be some system, right? Some
yes.
planning has to be some strategy.
Yes.
You just
planning.
Can't like, okay, I answered, I study, I go for the, no.
Planning
that won't
is very important.
Important. Why? Only because of time or because of the type of questions that come?
According to me, what I've noticed, like in the recent years, NEET, if you study NCERT, if you understand your concepts, you will be able to clear NEET very easily. But provided you understand the concepts, by hearting the textbooks is not enough. So people prefer to, you know, study many textbooks. But according to me, and may all teachers say this, you have to understand your basic textbooks first, 11th and 12th, then you go further. You
okay.
have to understand that first.
Okay. So how do you manage, like, suppose, okay, now I'm gone for the test. The papers come. How do you manage? Like, for example, okay, so many tests. Do you read everything first, or you keep on answering? Do you read the people? I remember when you in school, you say, "No, read the question paper first, and then you start." Will that work, or it's a waste of time?
Even in exams, like normal board exams, I used to. As soon as I get the paper, you automatically feel the desire, you know, whatever you know, just write it down.
Mm-hmm.
But then we have a 15 minutes reading time usually, so. For NEET, I used to start with the bio section first.
Okay.
Usually the bio section is last, like first is physics and chemistry, then bio. And most students prefer to answer bio as it's the easiest, like usually the easiest. So I don't read as such, but just, you know, answer each
start
question
with,
as it
okay.
comes.
Okay.
And also when you answer bio and you finish bio, the biology section, you realize that, you know, half your paper is done and you are answering the rest of the paper with much more confidence.
Okay. Now, you finished NEET. That's the first step after 12th. What do you want to do? Okay, I know you've applied for GMC, but is that your final goal, to get into GMC, or you're looking for something else? You're looking for what do you want to do? Your future?
I mean,
at least you're trying for.
Yes.
Aspiring to. Yeah.
I always wanted to go outside Goa.
Okay.
To study. And in the 12th, as I began to be more inclined towards, going for in the medical profession, that's when I came to know about Armed Forces Medical College. In the 12th, my teacher Miljan, she was my biology teacher, she mentioned about this college, Armed Forces Medical College in Pune, which she herself had tried for. She had gone to answer their entrance, because at that time there was no NEET. Most colleges had their separate entrance.
Own
entrance exam. So she mentioned about this, and I was curious to know, and I just researched at home, and I found this college really like just suited to my needs, exactly what I wanted. And that's when, you know, I got motivated, like, I want this college, I want to get into this college, and for that I need to study hard. That was the main thing.
Okay. Now, you spoke about medical. How did you, why do you want to get into medicine? Today, many people, from what I know, that now with this COVID and all, like, those who wanted to become doctors also don't want to become doctors. But you still want, what made you choose wanting to become a doctor? And from when did you always want to do it, or you lately, 11th, 12th, or even earlier? What was it?
I originally didn't want to become a doctor.
Okay.
I wasn't sure about what profession I would take till the 10th, 11th. I wasn't really concerned about that.
Okay.
So I would just, you know, study to, like, say, pass my boards and all that.
Okay.
So, but then gradually, like in school, I used to read books on herbal remedies. Say DIY remedies, and, you know, books on homeopathy, books on Ayurveda, just simple books. You get simple books which you can read and do your, you know, treat yourself.
Okay.
And I came across a book by Scott Peck, the author. He was a psychiatrist in the USA, and that's when I realized that this is where my true interest lies. I really want to do medicine. And even in biology in the 12th, there was in the 11th, there was a section human physiology.
Mm.
I found that really interesting. And I always had it in my mind that whatever I do, whichever career I choose, I want to help people.
Okay.
And I realized in the 12th, I want to become a doctor, but I hadn't really studied, you know, in the 11th. So I had to make up for all that.
Okay.
Yeah, so I wanted to do that. That's what made me, you know, study.
Okay. But your parents, did your parents encourage you to become a doctor, or they told you to become a doctor, or this was all you?
My father, somehow he had it, like, he thought, you know, I'm going to become a doctor, even though I never expressed like,
okay,
I want, but he had it, he never forced me, but he said, you know, you answer NEET, let's see. You might want to become a doctor in the future. So, like, it came through. Actually want to become a doctor. And my parents, you know, they said, whatever you want to do, you do it, we are with you.
Okay. Now, this is this part now, now future, what is going to be. You're going to apply for the medical college. And I'm sure so many more colleges also, I think. Yeah. So, tell us a little bit about yourself, your schooling. You have been a sports woman for a lot of times. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Let's know who is Abida.
I like to play sports a lot, like football, and even in school we had a lot of sports in school, that is Manavikas, handball, and athletics. I was in the athletic team in school, so I really used to enjoy running and cycling. So 400 meters, 800 meters, 5 kilometer, 10 kilometer jogging and runs. I used to compete in it inter school. I even reached the state level. State level, I came fourth.
Okay.
So I used to enjoy running, competing in sports, And even football, I really like football, watching football as well.
You played for Manavikal?
Yes.
Okay.
I was the captain in the 10th standard.
Okay.
Since the 5th, I used to... It was by chance, actually, that I came into football, but I enjoyed every moment.
How was
that
by chance?
In school, we used to have inter-house. We have houses
okay.
in school.
Yeah, correct.
So, inter-house football tournament.
Which house were you in?
I was in the blue house.
Okay, so was I. Yeah,
okay. So, they were falling short of players, the girls' team.
Okay.
So they were looking out, and then they saw me and my friend, and they asked us, "Are you interested?" Now we both of us didn't know how to play football. We just went on the field, kicked the ball whenever it came to us,
okay.
And that's when I realized that this is fun. This is actually very nice, and I continue to play.
Then you took some effort coaching and all that.
Yeah, in school itself. So
okay.
my teachers, then they, I was never good at running. With the help of my teachers, training, going in the morning for practices. I was very sports oriented in school, and
okay.
now also I am. But then I had to shift a little my focus towards studies as well.
Okay. So besides that, besides sport, tell us something about yourself.
I enjoy listening to music.
Okay.
So even during, when I was studying, I would just put Spotify, it's a music playing app.
Yeah, okay.
So just put on Spotify, open my favorite playlist and just play. So, it helps you relax. I enjoy listening to music. Then also I like exploring, like going out, meeting new people, going to new places. And especially natural surroundings and swimming, going to forest, going to the beach. Going to the beach is like one thing. Suppose I was really stressed, I would ask my parents, "Let's go out." So, my mother would take me to Benowli Beach, anywhere. Like, I used to enjoy being in the presence of nature.
You first part of your life, you were in Kankon. Then
yes.
you shifted to Naveli, Margao.
Yes.
But you are basically from Kankon, right?
Yes. My father is from Kankon and
okay.
my mother is from Kunkoli.
Okay. And then you all shifted to Margao.
Yes, my father, he, till the nursery I was in Kankon.
Okay.
And then my father realized that for educational purpose, it's better
yeah,
if it's we shift to Margao.
Okay.
So now also he travels from Margao to Kankon for his work.
I see.
Yeah, he travels by car daily to
okay.
and fro.
Okay,
yeah.
That's far. Yeah.
Yes, it is a lot.
It's quite a bit. Yeah, okay. Yeah, now... Avida, now we've come to almost the end of our this. So, what message do you have? Because you see, we in Goa, now maybe things are changing very slowly. But we don't have many girls who are getting into these competitive exams or want to get into the armed forces. Like just the other day, we had another very young, successful person. Who had got a commercial pilot's
yes.
license. So we don't have. So, what message would you give for girls your age, younger, who are getting into the 10th, getting into the 12th, especially 12th, like some sort of a message? What message would you like to give them?
The most important thing is to set a target for yourself, set a goal. Like whatever you want to do, whatever you have in mind, whatever dream you have, just go for it. Go slow, go fast, whatever your speed is, whatever you are capable of, but whatever you have, don't lose it. Whatever you say, you want to become an artist or a doctor, an engineer, or anything really, whatever you find, will give a meaning to your life, whatever you want to do. And in the future, we have to do something, of course. So we have to, whatever it is, set a goal for yourself, and that's when you'll get the passion and the motivation to achieve it.
And a lot of hard work.
Yes, hard work also. You just can't have a goal and expect that you'll come to it. It's a slow, steady process. But one day you'll get there, provided you put the hard work.
I like this concept of your slow and steady. Normally, but slow. I also feel that that's probably the best way to actually get...
Yes, it has helped me.
Yes, yeah. Thanks, Avida, for coming on our show. And... I would like to wish you the best of luck in your future, in whatever you want.
Thank you so much.
This was Abita Barreto, originally from Kankon, now of Margao, tomorrow we don't know from where. And she wants to be a doctor. More importantly, she wants to be an army doctor. Now, she has given a message to the youth, especially the girls, that you need to set goals, work steadily towards it, put in effort. Very good message, very mature for her age. We wish her the best of luck, Abita. And keep watching Goa 365.